important to make sure to preface a little bit about what you're going to hear, because you're going to hear two very, very, very different things, and the first of which is still very different in the first place. Kind of my backstory is I originally went and I followed music because I have a passion for video game music. It's what drew me to keep doing this beyond middle school and high school. I love video games and I love the music and I wanted to do more with it. So I went off to college and learned all about music as it were. It's always been my understanding that all music has a melody, it has background, it has chords, it has accompaniments, it has all this stuff that goes in and out. And Mozart is one way of bringing it to life, Beethoven is one way, but also any video game music or movie music composer brings that to life similarly. So the test with the first kind of two pieces or four movements that you'll hear is video game music, that the melody, the harmony, the accompaniment stuff is taken out of its aim focus, where it's just meant to go in circles for 50 seconds at a time and it goes endlessly in circles, but say, what if we took that out and just did something with it? What if we gave it a beginning? What if we gave it a middle? What if we gave it an end? And what if we made it do things? Anything beyond that of explaining the history of what games it's from or anything like that kind of gets away from the point that if it's truly successful, it doesn't really matter what game it's from. It should be just enjoyable music no matter what. I'm sure we're going to play for you You're Not Alone, which is from Final Fantasy IX, and then three little movements from a music arranged from the video game Super Mario World.
Thank you.
next thing, two things that we'll be performing goes kind of the other kind of style of what a trio ensemble can do, because there's classical trios. But outside of that, then there's also jazz trios, there's bluegrass trios, there's all kinds of trios that are not the traditional classical style. So we attempted bringing jazz to this format. What can we do with the string trio? So really all that we have and all that they're presented with here is the original melody, which is going to start with Leroy over there. And then there'll be quite a sizable section in the middle that's all improvisation. And I think neither of these guys had any experience with creating their own parts or improvising or anything like that before this week, so we spent quite a bit of time learning, you know, how do we make an improvisation that makes sense and fits with the piece and holds things together and does all of that. And then we finish it through in true jazz style with one final time through the tune. Both Ruben for the first time and Fiddle Thump then follow that same format.
Thank you. performance by Hannah Duncan playing the Sansonic production round with Capriccioso as a concerto competition winner, and we're going to be playing the Barbara Adagio for strings, which is just one of the most beautiful pieces ever written in the string instrument metaphor ever. So please join us for that. That concert will be next week, Friday, at 7 o'clock p.m. In the meantime, have a fantastic weekend and a great weekend. Thank you.
Yeah.